Inside the mosque, there were 12 pillars which were temple pillars. So normally the question comes, you know, in your mind also, how do you distinguish temple pillars from mosque pillars? Everything, because whether it is a mosque, whether it is a church, whether it is a temple, they have got certain features on the basis of which you can identify whether it is a temple, whether it is a mosque, or it's a church. Earlier we had got 12 temple pillars. But now, during, first of all, I mean, this communist historian said, no, this mosque has been built over virgin land. Virgin land means, I mean, below that there was no construction at all, no temple, nothing, nothing, not even been a civil constructions also. It was built over virgin land. Then the radar survey was conducted, that GPR survey, ground penetrating radar survey was conducted. So in which, you know, certain anomalies were detected. Then when it was further excavated, then we had got 12 temple pillars, but it was more than 50 pillars in 17 rows, stating that this was a huge temple of that period, the 12th century. So that was one thing. And the second thing was that pranala. Pranala means, I mean, every day if it is Shiva temple, Vishnu temple, you have to bathe it. And that Abhishega Jala goes through pranala. It is known as Makara pranala. Makara means a crocodile. So crocodile is a symbol of river Ganga. So if you go to North India, in front of Garbhagriha, there will be on the right side, there will be a lady standing on Makara, that is crocodile. There will be another lady on the left side standing on tortoise, which means that is Ganga and Yamuna. So you are having a symbolic bath in Ganga, Yamuna, and the underground Saraswati. And then after purifying yourself, you are going to Garbhagriha. So that is the concept. So this Makara Pranala was excavated from there. Had it been a Muslim, only exclusively a Muslim thing, then there would not have been this Makara Pranala. Then 263 idols were excavated. That is, terracotta idols were excavated. So in which, even Varaha was there. Varaha, we all know that it is, I mean, Malsi Kurma Varasya Narasinghi Vamanathide Ramo Ramas. So Varaha is one of the avatars. Then cobra was there. Then many animals were there. Then human figures were there, lady figures were there, drum was up, lady was there, a number of these things, you know. So none of them would have been could have been excavated from a mosque area. It is only from there. And then the most important thing was that this one, that is Amalka of the temple. Amalka means, in North Indian temples, you will be always having, like Aihole, Patadakal, Badami, and all these places, you will be having, just below Kalasha, you will be having the Amalka. Then the most, again the most important thing was that this one, Vishnu Hari Shila Phalak. It's an inscription of 20 lines in which it says that this temple is dedicated to that avatara who has killed Bali. So who has killed Bali? Rama. Then again it says who has killed 10-headed person. Who is 10-headed person?
Ravana.
So I mean, it is very clear. So it was on the basis of which archaeological survey in the second excavation said that there was a huge temple of this one dedicated to Vishnu. I mean, after the, I mean, before the I mean, below the mosque. So that whatever, I mean, this one, whatever report has been submitted by Archaeological Survey of India, that was fully acknowledged and accepted by the Honorable Supreme Court of India. And the judgment is on the basis of this particular excavation, which was conducted both by Dr. Mani and Dr. Bilalki.
Namma latest video galigagi Right Angle Media Ramge subscribe maadi, bell icon otti.